Hi guys, thank you for coming back. And this video today is about some few points about footwork. Moving with the opponent, footwork is very important to be able to keep our optimal distance, to be able to react with defense footwork or jiwaza, to mix up the rhythm, fake, break the rhythm, set up the attack, and choose when the interaction will take place. Few important rules. Sensei Nishiyama used to say, imagine you're walking on thin ice. Don't break it. So when you do your footwork, almost gliding. If it's forward, back, if I walk forward, right? Make sure you don't slap in the floor. Don't lift your foot up, just glide. Right? And this will allow you to, you know, be smooth, but any moment, something happen, pressure. Something happen, right? Pressure, technique start. Something happen, pressure to floor. Technique start. So any moment, ready to make pressure to floor. That's it, while you're moving, any moment ready, pressure to flow. Right? If you're not ready, pressure, right? Now your technique is going to be top technique and you cannot cover distance. So that's one thing. Make sure you don't jump, because every time I jump, see, I can use the flow until I come back down. So that's a cure. Right? If you see somebody jump, time it. When they're up, that's the time to attack. And so, don't jump and don't make too big footwork. Generally, try to make it small. And small meaning less space in between to attack you. Big means there's more in between. Also, small mean if I make mistake, I can fix. Small mistake, I can fix. If I make big mistake, more chance to come into me and attack. And generally, slide, Yori Ashi, front foot, back foot, back. Side with the same foot. Anytime you side shift, side step, make sure legs squeeze to each other, you come back to the same stance. Right? And always keep interaction between the feet. See, touch. Anytime, foot touch, reaction back. Right? So there's always like a loop, a cycle of energy. Anytime I shift, there's reaction. I can go any direction, yes. And sometimes we can use Tsugi Ashi. Right. Tsugi Ashi is good to close more distance. Right. But it's also good to hide. See, you don't see me coming at you. You don't. Right. So I can close more distance, but it's kind of hiding. Hiding your feet. Bam, shit comes in. But it's also risky because as I come in, there's no support like behind me. Right. So, usually disguise it with a punch, kind of don't let the opponent come in. Yes, disguise it with a punch, change to maybe kick. Yes, there's also Ayumi Ashi. Ayumi Ashi is just walking. Walk. So if I just walk, again the feet glide and try to feel like at any moment you can use either foot pressure. Bam, 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 I can use this foot, right? So while I walk to the opponent, don't have empty space, right? So any moment, either foot can make pressure. Either foot can make, right? And of course, you know, we have pivoting, right? Pivot, and side shift, of course. Sometimes I make distance, then side shift. Yes. So, I had to practice every day a few minutes, just moving, changing distance. Imagine somebody in front. You're keeping the space. And maybe you can have a signal. Like maybe every few seconds something, some sound, maybe for use your phone. Something happened, bam, reaction. You see, but no back motion. You see, you shouldn't move, press, then go. No. Feel like any moment, pressure means going. See, that's when I move, pressure is going. And maybe one more thing about footwork for today. You should be able to go back and keep the energy forward. Many people, when they go back, they're floating or the weight shift onto one leg and they get stuck. If a combination comes, you cannot react. So I actually like sometimes going back. But in the back, I'm looking for the chance because the opponent, when they come forward, sometimes they get eager. They feel that they have a chance. They might overextend. So if I have a chance, I can switch. Or even not as common sometimes, go back. I can go back. I back and attack same time, but that's more difficult. To be able to go back, but your momentum still have to transfer forward. And I say, my momentum, right? Still have to transfer forward. Right? So, footwork is extremely important to control the distance and the timing. Right? And control the timing and the distance, that's what we in the fight. Of course, you have to have strong technique. But footwork is essential. And then you have, you know, defense footwork. And I'll get into setting up footwork. Footwork for setup, for strategy, for creating a chance. Okay, guys, I hope this is useful. And please share and subscribe. Thank you so much. Peace.